What's good, Parlay?
What's cracking, baby boy?
Everything is good, man. So what are you up here? You got something big dropping next week.
Oh, y'all got this mixtape that I got. It's
a
mixtape.
It's really an album. It's not even fair to call it a mixtape, right?
I mean, yeah, it's a mixtape because you really ain't. I call them all my albums. They're mixtapes, you know what I mean? They ain't gonna really be my album until we got some real big money behind it. You know what I mean?
But you got original music. You got features. You got a lot of stuff. It's not the traditional, like, we're just going to make them. Like, you really put together a lot of original stuff and a lot of effort into this project, man.
I mean, mixtapes is cool. You know, you can always take somebody's style and flip it. You know what I mean? That's the easy part, you know? But what's the hard part is getting your originality and making it a mixtape and making it. Man, it's hot and it's not nobody else's music. It's all mine. So it's like, that's my whole thing. I'm just trying to show originality and show that I really, you know, do this. You know?
Parlay, like, you're sticking around for a minute, right?
Yes, sir.
Going down live from Los Angeles to Sirius XM Hip Hop Nation.
Yes, sir. I think I see where we're going.
That's Parlay, baby. We live. Live.
We about to drop that DJ SKEE Parlay mixtape next week. It's gonna be crazy.
I'm talking about bananas, right?
It's great. You got a bunch
Parlay,
of
baby.
Let's talk about your sound though. For people that don't know, you know, let's introduce you first. Who is Parlay? If people haven't heard of you yet.
Well,
how would you describe yourself?
I describe myself as a West Coast artist that's real versatile. You know, I'm from the ghetto. I'm from South Central and all that. But I'm not like really trying to portray myself as a gangster rapper. I'm trying to show that I can, you know, I'm all the way around the board with it. You know, I was raised by Pac, so all my music is really dealing with real life situations, you know what I mean? And
what's your favorite Pac album?
To be honest, I gotta go with 7 Day Cool Monogamy, man.
Like Melly, yeah. That was killer, man.
Yeah, when he was hanging on that cross, because he was really at the top of his game, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And that's really how this album right here, Parlay Starr, is gonna be. It's really like my last album that I got on iTunes right now, so Welcome to My World, and that was basically letting everybody know that I'm here and just really speaking up on how I am on the streets and my situations on the streets. Now, this new mixtape that you is presenting to them is a Parlay Starr album, and it's really basically talking about me and how I am personally, how fun I am, and how it's just more than gangsta. I'm just really letting everybody know how I am. You know what I mean?
Parlay Starr in the building. I want to talk to you about West Coast hip-hop and more in a second when we come back. We are live from L.A. West Coast right here, Hip Hop Nation. Don't touch that dial.
Don't touch that dial. That's part right there. Right, Ronnie, baby. Ronnie, man. But he's hating out here. Get off that porch. Walk your dog. At least walk your dog, nigga. Why you hating on Parlay in the motherfucking Wolf Pack? We bread boys. We starting to click called bread boys. Yeah, real talk, nigga. From this day forward, nigga, we the bread. Fuck the Wolf Pack. That's already used. Nigga, we the bread boys from here on out. Nigga, throwing up the double B's on the ass. Nigga, we bread boys. Off top today.
Parlay Starr, the builder, DJ SKEE. So you said you were just with Snoop.
DJ.
Stuff. What was Dog talking about, man? We just dropped that mixtape, of course, Puff Puff Pass Volume 3. Your mixtape's coming out next week. So what's up with Snoop, man?
Oh, Snoop, man, that's my boy. I've been dealing with Snoop for years, man. Actually, I was going to the Kevin Hart premiere of his new movie that's coming out. And I ran into him up there, and he was just up there chilling, doing Snoop, you know what I mean?
Of course, man.
I ain't seen Snoop in like 2 years.
Okay.
So when I seen him, it was just like, oh, man, and we chilled, and we did what we did, and we hollered. You know, really, I don't like talking business when we partying and all that. I never like talking business, but it was like, I ain't seen you in 2 years, Snoop, and I'm doing this, and he heard about the song I did with Chris Brown. So he was like, Parlay, woo, wah, wah, and I see doing your thing. And I said, yeah, man, I need you to come on and get on this train with me. He said, man, anything you need, Parlay. I mean, it's West Coast or nothing. And I'm like, I'm just glad for him to embrace me like that and, you know, to jump on a joint without no money, without no nothing, just doing out of pure love. You know, and that's what the West Coast is missing. We're missing the pure, genuine love, you know, to pat the next rapper on the back and say, man, come on, it's your turn. Come on, we're going to help you push or we're going to support your album, you know what I mean? Which a lot of West Coast rappers ain't doing. Like, when I holler at Glass and Malone and J-Rock and all them, I told them we need to get together as a unit. When we do shows, we need to all be together on our shows. When we do videos, we need to all be in each other's videos. When we do albums, we need to all support each other's albums. And that's how the West Coast will be able to come back. We got to show unity. When Death Row did it, it wasn't a lot of labels and a lot of groups. It was one entity. It was Death Row, and we had like six, seven artists that was hot, and they moved to West Coast.
Yes.
Now we're in this whole new era, and we have rappers that's hot, and we got fan base, YG, all of them. But we got to get together and move as a unit. Not everybody trying to move. Is he trying to do him? I'm trying to do me. Which is cool, but at the end of the day, every other state ain't doing it. Every other state is pushing. Down south, everybody jumping on people's stuff. East Coast, I go to the East Coast, they show me love. I got Royce the 5.
See the videos, man.
Yeah, man, they, you know, they show me love on the East Coast. So
I'm,
you know,
here
I'm just
now.
To incorporate that and bring that back to the West Coast. Like me, I deal with anybody and mess with anybody. You know what I mean? Even the underground rappers that look at me like, oh, Paulie, you make me up some Chris Brown, Kevin, et cetera, et cetera. You can do a song with me. All right, no problem. Here, bam. Get it while I'm not hot. When I get hot, I might got to put a price on it.
Parlay Starr in the building. This is DJ SKEE live from L.A.
Get it now, nigga. I'm going to have to put a price on it, nigga. You hear it live on the radio, nigga. West Side. Hello? Yeah. We seen the, you know. I'm enjoying my shit, man. Me and my nigga Mark, man, we enjoying this shit, man. Because usually, we be in the studio listening to this shit. You know what I mean?
We celebrating now.
Yeah, so now we can actually sit back in the car and really get the full, we can really take it all in now because we like really on the radio, listen to it on the radio. We not in a studio in the world listening to it. We really sitting on the motherfucking consumer side. And it's a good feeling listening to yourself on the radio, man. Me and my nigga Mark, we grind. We put in a little 16-month grind and got us where we at now, man. 16 months. I mean, I've been in this shit 11 years. But the last 16 months, we done made big power moves that then, you know, just broke me, you know, broke Parlay Starr all the way through where we needed to be.
What we do? Knock down doors.
Not taking no as an answer. Like I've been saying in all my radio interviews, it's the laws of average. A lot of people don't understand that. That's why I'm putting it out there, man.
That's it, man. If you don't want to say it, I'm going to say it. All you fake-ass rappers that have been holding him back, it's a shame. Because he landed in my lap.
DJ SKEE, Parlay Starr. We're about to drop this new mixtape next week. You got a few features on there, a bunch of other things. I've seen some videos, too, of you going at a couple cats online and stuff, too. Do you want to speak on that real quick?
Yeah, it's just, like I said, man, it all goes back to the loyalty of this game. You know what I mean? And me, before I was even a rapper, I was a street guy. You know what I mean? And it's a lot of rappers that I've met that I'm dealing with right now. And I didn't meet them on rap. I met them as being genuine friends.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it went from me being general friends to me protecting certain rappers. I don't want to say their names, I guess. But certain rappers I didn't, like, look out for and put my life on the line and did all kind of crap for them. And then at the end of the day, they turned around and, like, just left me hanging. You know what I mean? Like, and I feel if I put my life and my freedom on the line, because I got four kids, so if I come out of my house and put my life and freedom on the line for you, man, come on, you gotta at least pat me on my back, you know what I mean? You don't just leave me hanging like that, you know what I mean? Certain rappers left me dry after I done looked out for them, and, you know, I ain't mad at them, you know, I ain't mad at Yuck Mouth, I'm tired of them dudes, you know, I see them in trouble. The best way to, you know, break them off is success.
Yeah, what do you think about that? Do you want to, because it's like, you know, especially you being a new artist, it's kind of tough to start beef. It's like, people are like, oh, he's just doing it for attention. He's just doing it for that and stuff. Like, look, how do you keep that balance of, like, you know, actually speaking on things that you feel you should versus, like, man, people aren't going to take it. You know what I mean? Because sometimes the beef stuff, and making sure it doesn't get to another stupid level, too.
No, you're absolutely right. And that's why when I do beef songs, like, I'm not really no beef rapper, but if it really comes to that, my name Parlay, I mean, I just chill.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm mad at you, evidently you did something. So my whole thing is when I did that song with Dissing Tiger, I didn't really like say F you and you a fake rapper or none of that. I just really told the real on what happened. If you really listen to that song and listen to the lyrics, you can hear what I'm talking about. I gave you a chance to make it up. Tiger stole my song, my Chris Brown song. He stole it. The vocals, man, he's a thief. He stole my music and he aired it out. He put a Young Money drop on it and aired out my song that's supposed to introduce me to the world. Chris Brown blessed me with a hook that's supposed to brought my single on the indigo. This Parlay, woo wee hide, he the next woo woo woo. He leaked it out. So now when I came out with the song, everybody looking at me like, how you on a remix? This Tiger and Chris Brown song. So I told Tiger, come on, make it up. I'll give you a whole year. I mean, just jump on another song. I'm not really tripping. Let's just do another song. I'm going to get Chris on it, and let's do it. He just shot me off, changed his number, ignored me. I went to shows. Me and Chris, we did shows with Wiz Khalif. He acted like he didn't know me. So, I brushed it off because he's a youngster. You know, he ain't really on my level. But at the same time, I ain't going to just let you F open me. You know what I mean? It's on its own.
It's real tough.
You know, the beef, more like I'm not beefing you as far as, oh, I think I'm better than you. It's a real legitimate beef. You stole from me. Give me what I owe and we can be friends again. We can be buddy, high five and West Coast or nothing.
Well, let's go ahead. Let's actually play this record right now. Take it away. I'll let you go ahead and introduce it. It's off the mixtape that drops next week. You might have heard it already. If not, it's new to you right here. Live from LA Parlay. Take it away. Introduce it.
For sure. This is my remix right here. This is a whole little song I was talking about with Tiger. It's called Like You, but this is the remix. You know what I mean? I took it off. I got 1500 that did the track. It's called Like You. Got Kevin McCall on it. It got Beretta on there. It got my boy Nutso from the Outlaws. He was just going ham on it. You know what I mean? We just going ham. And ladies love it.
He's supposed to cut
off. Everybody love it out there. Go get it. It's on iTunes. I got an album on iTunes. And hit me up on Twitter. And let's go. Let's get it.
Trench coat, black thighs.
That's my song, baby. Back,
shoot it in the sky. I live by you, my bride. Load you up, it's hammer time. Hell yeah, I'ma handle mine. But that's just for one night. I'ma love you right.
We grinding, baby.
Protect my life.
Suckers out there, all you haters, I ain't gonna even get mad at it. I'm just letting my success kill it. Hard work.
Remember you forever, my.
Yeah. Well, I'm on the radio, baby. This time I'm on the outside, you know, listening to it. I ain't in the studio. You know, I get the luxury to sit here and just listen to this shit. This is big.
Yeah, she's on like Donkey Kong. She got a body like a model showing off a clone. She wanna put it in the mouth because she know that I'm against all these streets. I'm a beast, she knows strong. Been the paper long, I gotta cash it in. She just wanna be my homie, love a friend. But I'ma set it all, Patty's and bra. About a Hollywood sign, good cush, don't play it all. She got a super jaw with that idol look. Call her Pocahontas, stress out the playboy book. She likes to scream and squirt, I think she like what it hurt. I put it deep in the beat, and she cut to the flow. And she begging for more, she wanna touch the sky. G6, she's gifted, mile high. I'm so uplifted, creamy thighs. On the wheels, I'ma cheer, but just take a dive. When I'm on the road, baby, stop me up. On my laptop, posted on my tour bus. She don't give a what, she'll play with us. She'll find that I say I'm on the buzz and stuff. Just to give it up, that's the winner to me. I'ma keep her around, she's strip for me. She's the MVP, I'm talking about to be the shit. Take a last shot, just to keep it falling free. Black.
This ain't our Kelly song, we gon' skip the 12, play. Girl, I'm on that hush. We gon' do this my way. I play, no games, go hard, no shame. Girl, I'm like an animal, uncaged, untamed. Pain. Say he wants it love. When I step on that, I see what he was saying.
It's like heaven when I'm with her.
Ain't no beginning at
all. Live, baby.
This one's a professional.
You sit in the lack truck.
From the black seat.
Found it. Got my nigga Skrilla in the back. Got my nigga Skrilla in the back. I can handle it. Represent Harlem. Yeah. Crim de la Crump. You looking out for my nigga Crim de la Crump from Harlem, baby. Parlay fucking with him.
You sitting there parlaying, man. I'm in Harlem right now, sitting at the General Grant Projects with my nigga Creme de la Creme. And, you know, we just celebrating, sitting here, you know, listening to my shit on the radio, man. It's a big pleasure, and I'm honored, and I just thank God. And we just out here chilling, blowing some this Harlem weed, making it do what it do, homie. That part right there. Shit is official. For all you haters out there, yeah. Keep on hating, nigga, but my moves prove different, nigga.
You already know what it is, DJ Skee, Sirius XM, Hip Hop Nation, Parlay Star. We got the mixtape dropping next week. It's gonna be crazy.
Yeah.
You ready, man? Yeah. We've been working on it for a minute, man.
Oh, yeah, I've been taking my time with this one, man, because I'm really like, there ain't no margin for error for me right now.
And who's putting it out? Let's talk about your crew and stuff, your label. You guys are kind of doing it independent and yourself.
Oh, yeah, Most Hated Mob Entertainment. You know, we're doing all independent. You know, we didn't pass up a couple of deals because we feel, hey.
How you got to do it, man?
Hey.
How important is it to be independent, too, just so you can speak on what you want to do and kind of have control your own destiny? Because having a deal isn't what it used to be, man.
No, not at all. You know, and right now, they ain't even really giving you real deals. They give you single deals, you know what I mean? So it's like, you better off independent. The thing about independent is the only thing that you got to do with independent, is all marketing.
Okay.
You know what I mean? If you ain't got no fan base, I don't even know why you're independent. You know what I mean? So that's basically what I'm working on right now. I got a fan base, but I'm trying to build my fan base. So really, all my money's going in the market. You know what I mean? That's why I love Tech N9ne.
Damn, man.
Tech N9ne is getting his bread.
Killing the chef.
And he's not even worrying about getting no deal.
My guy, man.
You know what I mean?
That's who you should, that's who rappers should follow in his footsteps.
Yeah, that's who I'm following. You know what I mean? I just bought a house in Montana, man.
Yeah, man.
And they love.
Yeah, we were talking about that off air.
Oh, man, they love Tech out there, man. Every show he do, and he almost do a show every month out there. They sell out.
Crazy. Good, good business, right?
Oh, great business. You know what I mean? So, shouts out to Tech, man, and that's what I'm doing, man. I'm following his footsteps, and hopefully I can be successful or even, you know, a little better than him. You know what I mean?
Let's get it, man. Well, look out for the mixtape next week. Parlay, thanks for hanging out all night long right here, live from Los Angeles.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And I want to give a shout out to my boy DJ SKEE, one of the hottest, matter of fact, the hottest West Coast DJ that I done ran across. You know what I mean?
We try and shout out to homie Mark Two, Most Stage Mob Entertainment. The mixtape drops next week. Parlay Starr, DJ SKEE. That's going to be a classic.
Hit me up on Twitter, Parlay Starr, Parlay Starr.
Let's get it, man. We out of here live from LA. See y'all next week.
Stop. Can't get enough.